In this video, I'm going to simplify cropping, whether you want to crop to an aspect ratio or you want to crop to a specific size for printing. You don't have to do any math. Photoshop will do it all for you. I'll show you how. Hey everyone, Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com. Let's jump in and look at cropping. So cropping, the first thing we want to do is grab the crop tool, which you'll see in the toolbar on the left. Now there's two different ways of working. One is an aspect ratio and one is a size. We're going to start with aspect ratio. So aspect ratio doesn't care about the size, just the shape. Think of this as a pizza and we're going to cut it into maybe a square shape. So we're going to do a 1:1 aspect ratio. Now this is a square. Notice I can resize it. By the way, if you hit the Alt or the Option, you can go from the center. And what happens is when I apply this, it's not going to resize anything. All it's going to simply do is just crop it into that shape. Or you may want to do something like a 4:5. And by the way, the first number on the left is always the width. The second number is always the height. Now you might do something like that, you know, for an Instagram crop or something like that. Common aspect ratios are 4:5 for Instagram, 1:1 to get a square, and another one is 16:9, which is used for HD or video. And in fact, you'll see these under the presets. The next option is to get an image to a specific size, whether that be screen resolution or a print resolution. So here's the important thing. We no longer want to use ratio. We want to do W+H, which is width, height, and resolution. You're now going to see an additional box here for resolution. This is important if you want to recrop it to a certain size. Say we want to do a 4:5 image. Notice it puts pixels by default. All we need to do is just type in IN to change this to inches. Same with here. And of course you can do centimeters, millimeters, whatever you want. And then we need to put a resolution in. I'm just going to put in 300. And at this point, what it does is it creates this window. Now we can resize this window. Notice as I'm dragging the corner, I'm resizing it. I'm able to reposition. Remember, this is a window. So I drag the photo around to compose it in here. Now, of course, if you prefer the old behavior, just hit this little gear and choose classic mode. And now when I use classic mode, now we're actually just changing the crop and the image is staying still. So depending on how you like to work. Personally, I like the new mode, I'm used to it. But the thing is, when I hit enter, this is gonna make this 4:5 at 300, no matter what I do. So whether I do this on a really small part of the photo, or I do it on a very large part of the photo, when I hit enter, it's going to change the size of the pixels so that this image becomes 4:5 at 300 pixels per inch. So now we're creating a 1920x1080. So this would be HD resolution. And if I hit enter or hit the check mark, look at this, it's 1920x1080. Let me undo that. Let's make it bigger. Do a larger one, apply it, still 1920x1080. Let's do 5:5 and draw out our box. Hit enter. And if we want to see what this is, let's just choose image size. If we put this into inches, look, yep, 5:5. So this will always resize to what you want. Couple more little things I want to show you. Here's a tip. When you want to output this and you don't want to change your original file, choose File, Save a Copy, and make a copy and put that size in the file name so you don't overwrite the original. When you are resizing this, here's a little tip. If you hit the X key, you can change the aspect ratio from portrait to landscape. When I grab the crop tool, as you can see here, the overlay, we can change it. Tap the O key. Each time you tap it, it goes through a different type of overlay. Rule of thirds, golden mean, these will help you. Let me get out of the classic mode And if I want to enlarge this, see how we've got that transparent area? If I turn on content aware and hit enter, we'll hit the check mark. It's actually going to do content aware fill on the edge so we can actually expand the size of it if we want to. Let's look at option, which is delete crop pixels. If that option is turned off, once we apply this crop just by hitting enter or the check mark, if I choose the move tool, which would be the V key, this just becomes a window and I can move it around. Now this window is the set size, but we can literally just recompose this how we want it. The other option is if we turn on delete crop pixels and I hit enter, this is actually going to crop it to that size, which means that those pixels are now removed. All right, so I attempted to make the crop tool easy for you. Let me know in the comments underneath if you learned anything new and what was the most useful part of this tutorial. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider subscribing, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And if you like this, do me a favor, hit that like button, a thumbs up. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm, so on YouTube there. So anyway, guys, until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.